been on the Hill here for a number of years. So I know a lot of people and a lot of people I don't know, but I know that everybody that Jim knew or Jim was friends with, and they're all good friends, so I think we're all probably going to be good friends as well. I met Jim about 19 years ago at a place called the Morgan Rose Men's Club. And he loved socializing with people, and he touched many lives. He was attentive. He listened to your problems, offered solutions when he could. He loved and was loved. He had a great sense of humor. He always had a smile on his face. And was just a social butterfly. So you would see him everywhere, always talking to somebody and learning something. One of his favorite things was to remember the names of somebody some odd years ago, and just to test his memory and make sure he was still clicking along there in the memory. So at our first meeting years ago, he thought I was some kind of a CIA or FBI agent or something like that. He just always looked at me a little sideways, and he come to find out that I was just an engineer in the high-tech industry with a love of motorcycles, fishing, and adventure, pretty much the same as him. Also like to tip a drink once in a while, same as him. And he always had a smile on his face. And we've spent many hours together talking about meaningful things and meaningless things. You know how guys are. And one of the things that I've taken to heart is that he used to say, I like to plan my work and work my plan. And I've really taken that to heart. I say that a lot now and passing it on to the youngsters. And one of the time we were out, we met at Detroit Lake, and he had an RV pad out, the first spot out there. He said, come on out, we'll go camping. And I said, all right. So I showed up on my Harley Davidson and unfurled my gear, my tent, put out my little chair, put on my flip-flops, and sat down, cracked a beer. He just said, boy, you make that look good. And about a month later, he bought a street bike. And we went on many rides together, and it was fun. He had a lot of bikes. Kept telling him, get a big bike. Don't keep getting these little bikes, and just get the big one and go for it. Well, he finally got the big one. It's three wheels. That's how big it is. I figured, you know, Jim, he kind of always wanted to park up front so he didn't have to walk so far, you know, to get to the beer. And just kind of being lazy, just didn't want to put his feet down and balance at stop signs. So I think that was a perfect vehicle for him. But he was loved, and I think we all know that. I think that's why we're all here. He was touched by, or he touched many of our lives. And let's just say farewell. We go wheeling with the angels. And cheers. Cheers, Jim.
Cheers.